So, yeah, last week was really, jumping from the frying pan into the fire. So, after all that anxiety about the US vote and waiting for all the results and everything, it's not so important here. And it was not like I was getting sleepless nights, but it was quite interesting and strange. My daughter was put on quarantine since they had a positive corona case. And here in Hessen, we have a special mixture of quarantine rules. So my son is not technically in quarantine, but he can't go to school. So my daughter has not to be alone when I have to work Monday till Friday, but he cannot go to school, so we are, and I'm at home as well, so we are de facto on almost full quarantine lockdown. You are not quite, and we can go shopping and stuff like that, but, or at least I can, or my wife can. But yeah, it will be interesting. And but one thing which has been going through my head, and in the with this numbers, with the US election and with the corona numbers, which is very similar. So I think it's really, it was this thing when on the election night, like the first results came in and the numbers looked so. Yeah, it was it changed very much over the time, but it was like on some states it was looking like, oh, this has to go in a certain direction, but it turned out totally different and was like it was very hard to understand, let's see. So if you just like, I have been quite good in mathematics, but if you look on it and just do a head calculation, it does not fit quite. And I think this is something which is similar with the corona numbers, where we have the highest numbers in Germany we ever had, but our the in we always looking on the index how many people are infected. So we have like 0.8, so one. Like if you have 100 infected, they infect 80 people roundabout. So if it's 0.8, if it's like 100 people would infect 200 people. So what you would be thinking, if we have a number of 0.8 and we have most and it's getting more, how does this work? But the whole thing is it's screwed through time, because we have like the testing results takes like between 24 and 64 hours, or six, yeah, so like between 2 and 3 days till those results come in. So everything we do now, like shutdowns, this comes into play much later. And yeah, we have the light turning off here, so it's a terrible studio. Well, let's just blind everybody by putting it back on. Ah, it's not as bad as I thought. So yeah, but like all the measures we are taking now, we have like you can meet maximum people from two families, I think maximum 10 people at all or something. Same thing with my son not being able to go to school because his sister is in quarantine for being a contact person, but they won't test her unless she has some symptoms. So we have to do a symptom lock now. They measure her temperature twice a day, write it all down, and the officials will always call us regularly, maybe, and ask for that data. So that's going on. So yeah, this will be the next 2 weeks, I think. Yeah, at least my daughter is not quite alone, and so that will be better. And yeah, we have class teacher. I'm in contact with her, so we'll figure out how to make sure that he falls not back too much into school. I don't think it will be a big thing for him if it stays at 2 weeks. But yeah, I think we should keep it and should keep the level so that he does not have to step back too many steps to keep the pace of the class and yeah, learn the letters and stuff like this. But yeah, of course we have much less time than in school, and we're probably much worse teachers than real teachers. So yeah, I think overall it will not be a big trouble if it stays with 2 weeks, but yeah, we'll figure this out with the teacher when she calls me, and then I give you an update. So That's that, but yeah, with the numbers thing, numbers things, think it's very similar with the US, counting the US vote. And at this point, it looks like Biden will be the next president, but it's not, it's like I think 95% sure. I hope tomorrow we will have some clearance there because, yeah, I would say I'm almost anxiety resistant, but not quite. So it has been on my mind. So it's not like I'm losing sleep or something, but something I have to check regularly. And yeah, and I see this parallel now, and I think it makes me understand Corona and the Corona numbers much better. So this is unless you think it's all fake on both sides, but I think it makes it clearer how it's not as easy to understand as I thought it would be. So, or it's like it's the same thing we had 2 weeks ago with knowing and understanding and experiencing something. So yeah, the math is quite okay and I can understand the math, but experiencing it, having this experience that it rolls over you, what you calculated in your head, that's interesting at least, and but it broadens the vision a little bit, I think. No wormholes then. Ninety, what's this, 90, 92 years old. Risk patient for coronas then. So, I need to get my wife from work, and it was a really beautiful, bright day when I brought her there, and so I forgot my normal glasses in the car. So I have to walk around with sunglasses, glasses in the middle of the night here, yeah? And I'm already, I spooked myself a little bit because yeah, I was responding to a comment from Best VV Running Don and about Halloween videos, and I was thinking, oh, what gruesome stories and places we have, and yeah, you shouldn't do this in the middle of the night, really. I really don't like being spooked. Being spooked by your own mind is probably the worst kind of getting spooked than walking around in the middle of the night with sunglasses. Does not improve on the whole situation, yeah. I think I really like, for example, horror movies. I really don't like horror movies at all. And I think it's like when I was a child, I was really afraid of the dark, or especially like the situation when you go up, when you're in a dark stairwell in the cellar and you go up, and like the light disconnects, and I really do not enjoy the feeling having a dark stairwell behind me. Or it was really, really bad when I was a child. Still very uncomfortable, but I can deal with it. Say, but yeah, I really do not enjoy any kind of spooking, or very rarely I watch any horror movies. Oh, seems Biden won the presidential election, so at least that chaos is sorted out, so yeah. We are in quarantine, yay. So we can watch all the Star Wars movies in one go or something.
So, I and my son, we are going to throw away the waste paper on behalf of my wife. Despite us being catched up at the house today. We might also can't leave the house due to quarantine, so we boys have to do it. Wow, look what a beautiful autumn day this is today. And yeah, my daughter has to stay at home, so and my son, we are going to throw away the fresh paper. And yeah, then it's probably going to be Star Wars. And I kind of decided on watching Episode 1, 2, 5, 6, 3, so it's like the Darth Vader cringe thing where you get to know Anakin Skywalker, and then you find out that Dark Vader killed him and he wants revenge, and then there's the big reveal that he's himself. Oh, we went to the wrong place, yeah. Yeah, the car's on the other parking ground. Because it's Sunday, yeah. We can use the parking near the home because... But yeah, I want to throw away a little bit of glass. That's the collecting stage. No, it's gone. I need to go back to home because, of course, that's where the car is.
The white mask there is geese. They have like the hatchery there, and they're always running around there. And usually they should be quite ripe for slaughter now. Because on St. Martin's Day, it's usually the day where they, well, Christmas, they get eaten. But I think this year, they're probably in good luck to have guys, because cool stuff is getting cancer. Kingfishers sitting there on a field just a couple of meters back, but of course they aren't fast enough and filming for that, but yeah, it's a really beautiful day. Really beautiful, yeah. Yeah. Really cleaning up that thing is that it was like an old pub. So like houses in this area are extremely cheap. So cheap that I'm almost thinking about buying a second one just for having a space to store our RVs. Something like that. Yeah. RV, we buy the RV, did put up a little bit back, so we have to kind of spend a little less, I guess. Yeah. But yeah, really beautiful day. Yeah, yet a quite beautiful place, and it's like here.
That this makes you that remind me of Tyrion, so that tank machen, and then müssen leider die Soldaten mit Corona sobrevieren, weil die Corona
the end of the world here.
Aber sie können nicht gleich noch Corona kontrollieren.
Nach 400 Metern rechts abbiegen.
Das kann nicht so weit laufen, muss nur. Darf man nicht anhalten.
I was sent out to get hot dogs, material for producing hot dogs. That's what I'm doing, and I'm usually choosing, as always, the more beautiful and probably also safer route, at least from cars. That is, it's probably much, much better for muggers, but yeah, it's quite valid. And pity the fool who tries to mug me, I guess. That's not so common thing in small villages anyway. So yeah, another day. I was thinking I had the whole day I had like the Phil Collins song Another Day in Paradise, and like the Mock lyrics Another Day in Quarantine. Yeah, we could sing a little bit better. That would be a nice video, I guess, or could be potentially. Let's see how that idea turns out.
So, James has his new favorite place there, safe from all kids.
James Pockens.
Yeah, it's already Friday, so couldn't think to get something to eat from the weekly market, and yeah. So nothing else is happening besides me getting really, really bulky. Ah, once again. So, yeah. I should charge the batteries on the RV.
Yeah, so this week was not really successful, I would say. Actually, I went to the market to get something to eat today, and there was like an ambulance and another ambulance and like the emergency doctor car, and I was what's going on? And then the police came up, and they were all in the same file for the eating stand. So I had I spent like 45 minutes there in the waiting for getting something to eat for the kids. So I spent my lunch break there. Then couldn't catch my wife, which I'm probably in trouble in now, but yeah, I had an upgrade set for my PC, and I installed that new CPU, the new mainboard, new RAM, so and that's quite good, yeah, now. Because, yeah, we had this PC like on the attic for over a year or 2 years or something, sitting, and yeah, quite happy we got it back, revived it, and one very interesting thing with that PC, last quarantine at the start of the year, I gave it a little bit more RAM, and I got I asked my brother if he had a graphics card lying around, and got his old graphics card, and it's running. It was running quite good with the i5-750, so CPU from 2009, and I remember times of when I was more in PC building and modifying. That was like the early 2000s, and back then when you bought a computer with top spec hardware, and I did this once in my life, and it's really something you should absolutely never ever do that. But I did this once, and it's like half a year later that thing was worthless. It was not fast anymore, so it was really a bad time back then. And it was when my father had his store in the late 90s and such, so we had all the access to cheap components, and that, and we built stuff in school. We had like a group where one teacher organized that, and we were building computers in after school and stuff like that. So this was what we were doing. So but I have been out of that for several years. Yeah, and actually I think that the only really bad thing about the old computer was the CPU cooler, which I just like 2 pounds of metal, and it's humongous. It's really I'm not quite sure if my brother wanted to compensate for something there, but yeah, this is the reason we got this big case, because we wanted to, or I think around when my son was born or before, I bought like the old components for my brother and wanted to put them in my old Dell computer, but that cooler wouldn't fit. So it's like it barely fits in that humongous case here. So I think it's like half as heavy now that we got that cooler out there. And it's really, I made our own video on that, so you can watch this on my tech channel. But yeah, all right. Replace the stuff, and I'm quite happy with that. Now the only thing we need to get working is working out, because yeah, I've gained so much weight already. Once more, it's really terrible, but it's really hard, yeah, because working at home is not it's actually harder than working and work, I guess. But different, but now especially with my kids here quarantined, can be quite taxing. So but yeah, we got our projector set up here. Not quite sure if you have shown this. So got like the screen there where we can project onto, And got a projector there, and we got our Nintendo Switch there, and we got the fitness games. Something we have to get. Just do it, huh? That's all, but yeah, a bit like we wanted to do it, put it on the back wall there, but then we thought it was exactly fitting into the doorway here. So we have like a storage space here, so we could do fitness and not the whole village would be seeing you. But yeah, actually, when my kids were playing, I watched from outside, and you can't really see that much anyway. But yeah, same. That's the update for this week. Still on quarantine. I think on Wednesday the kids can go back. Everything runs fine in school, certainly. Not quite sure about kindergarten, because the whole group was closed down. I got no further information, but I presume it's going back to normal on Wednesday. No, is it Wednesday? Because on Wednesday or Tuesday, but it's just 2 to 3 more days of quarantine anyway. Okay. We have a calendar for the last half year here. So the 17th is the last day of quarantine, the 18th will be the back to school day, and I think my son will have little problems. We did a video chat with the teacher yesterday, because she wanted to try it out, and yeah, they're using an open platform. It's not so complicated, but it's like, it's not that complicated, it's just one click, and those sentences usually form famous last words, and I recognized it quite when we had the last lockdown. We had like this thing going on, or in my company we had started with Skype and remote meetings like 2019, early to mid 2019, and the first Skype calls and how getting the people to mute their mics and everything, that was really terrible, so to say. And we are all tech savvy people, so that's like I'm in the technology department of a technology company, so but the first steps were hard. And the first meetings were horrible, but we did this before Corona, so we had like a little bit of an advantage. And another thing was there was a big rail outage. I think 3 months before the lockdown, and there many people started working at home, and the network collapsed. And we didn't notice this because we were in the company, but they had the network connection bandwidth extended, and that was also quite helpful. So if it hadn't the first couple of weeks would have been really, really bad and horrible, and with all the shortage of components and everything. So we had it quite good in that regard. We had accidentally prepared ourselves for the whole situation a little bit. So same here with the school. You only need like a meeting link, which in a perfect world would be easy to remember, everybody could use it, but it's like 26 cryptic characters, and yeah, so that's not possible there. So you have to send it electronically, and then the application probably remembers it. Same, and so I used the cell phone and she used her computer. And yeah, we got it to work, but it took some time, and maybe it's smoother next time, or I hope so. Like, figure out you have to send the code, because it's a complicated code, because it has to be secure, because it's Germany, and it's kids in Germany, and somebody could log into the class group chat and see the kids chatting, and that would be terrible. But yeah, the first grade, yeah. So, yeah. We have to share that code before via email or something. Then everybody can log in, and then it should work forever. But like, In that app, it's not default that your microphone is muted when you connect. It was probably easier with the kids, but if you have 20 persons in a group chat and every microphone is engaged, it sounds like a recipe for really, really bad feedback loops or something. Yep. So, see how we are going out of the wife needs to work on next weekend, so yeah. Probably not going to be as interesting, and my daughter still can't leave the home technically, so and if she can't go, we won't go, so just stay there. So nothing much should be happening next week as well.